the global shift of industrial manufacture from the West to the Middle East and Asia gives added significance to the transportation of industrial bulk liquid chemicals by sea. Both the volumes and the variety of chemicals now transported requires the use of more sophisticated technologies, governed by more effective international regulations. In part one of this series, Cargoes, Ships and Legislation, we look at some examples of typical chemicals carried on board, the exacting technical requirements of chemical tankers, the handling and control requirements during loading, at sea, and at discharge, tank washing, and emergency procedures. Throughout the program, we also describe how regulatory requirements ensure the safety of ship's personnel, the cargo, and the ship. Working on board a chemical tanker also means knowing what to do to prevent pollution. This is an important topic and is the subject of part two of this series, Prevention of Pollution on Board Chemical Tankers. MARPOL Annex 2 divides bulk liquid chemicals into three categories, X, Y, and Z, in the order of their degree of hazard to the environment, category X being the most hazardous. In an emergency, each cargo will have specific requirements and procedures to be applied. These must be strictly followed, as the response action will vary depending on the nature of the cargo and the volume of spill. But pollution control is not confined only to emergencies. MARPOL Annex 2 sets out measures to control pollution from accidental discharges and from operational procedures such as tank cleaning. This includes regulating the discharge of residues or contaminated tank washing. The latest version of the Chemical Tanker Operations series continues to provide the tools to keep officers and crew up to date with current regulations and good operational practice.